The Hong Kong HKSAR government announced the disqualification of four Legislative Council members following a decision adopted by China's top legislature. The four LegCo members are Alvin Yang, Dennis Kwok, Kwok Kai-ki, and Kenneth Liang, all of them sixth-term LegCo members. According to the NPC Standing Committee decision, LegCo members shall be disqualified for the office once they are determined by law to have failed to meet the legal requirements of upholding Hong Kong HKSAR basic law and honoring the pledge of allegiance to the Hong Kong HKSAR. The nominations of the four LegCo members to stand for the seventh term LegCo election were invalidated on July 30th since they were not in compliance with the requirement under the Legislative Council Ordinance. According to the Legislative Council Ordinance, candidates for LegCo elections are required to sign a declaration in accordance with the statutory nominating procedure, clearly stating that they will uphold the Hong Kong HKSAR basic law and honor their pledge of allegiance to the Hong Kong HKSAR.
做议员的人都一定要拥护跟支持那个基本法，然后就是我们要履行我们立法会议员的职责的时候，我们一定要遵从我们的誓言。我希望这次常委会做的决定能够让我们的香港立法会的议会里面能够以前的那个乱象呢就可以停止了。
我们可以回复那个正轨。对这些反对派，他们一直所作所为，可以说是胡作非为的，就是妨碍了特区政府的执政，妨碍了民生经济。人大常委会的决定呢，绝对是合情合理、合法合宪。
这次人大常委会取消那些不能真正拥护基本法，甚至明里暗里支持港独的议员履职资格，可以说是在关键时刻做出一个事关香港未来走向和命运的关键性的决定，可谓是大快人心。这个决定不但具有充分的法律基础，并包含了明确的政治伦理。 而且具有坚实的民意基础，更是牢牢把控"一国两制"正确的方向。
香港回归已经23年了嘛，那爱国爱港应该是成为香港社会的主流，而且呢，应该成为香港社会香港的公职人员的这种主流才对。这个决定呢，是重新确立了爱国者治港的这个政治的要求。